Hello everybody, welcome once again to this video about Riemann sums. So here we have to calculate a limit using Riemann sums. The exercise says let f be a function of class C2, which means f is twice differentiable and the second derivative is continuous. Find the limit of n squared. The integral from 0 to 1, f of x dx minus n, the sum from k equal 1 to n, f of 2k minus 1 over 2n when n goes to plus infinity. Here we have some preparation to this end. Once we can use this equivalent or exact formula. This formula is equal to the sum from k equal 1 to n integral from k minus 1 over n to k over n f of x dx. This is one. The second, we have f of 2k minus 1 over 2n. This is equal to the integral from k minus 1 over n to k over n f of 2k minus 1 over 2n 1 over n. So we have these two formula. We will use them together to get a new formula of this limit. Let's denote by an. This is n squared integral from 0 to 1 f of x dx minus n, the sum from k equal 1 to n f of 2k minus 1 over 2n. Using these two formula, we can get this is n square. Here we have 1 over n. We have n because we have k over n minus k plus 1 over n. We get 1 over n. So we times by n to get exactly this one. Yeah, n square times. The sum from k equal 1 to n, the integral from k minus 1 over n to k over n, f of x minus f of 2k minus 1 over 2n dx. Now just we use these two formula. Don't forget that f is twice differentiable and the second derivative is continuous. Then we can pretend to use Taylor expansion to this function with Lagrange remainder. N x minus 2k minus 1 over 2n plus the second derivative plus f twice theta x index k over 2 times x minus 2k minus 1 over 2n square. Then we will replace this expression by this expression. This allows us to write En. This is equal to n square times the sum from k equal 1 to n integral from k minus 1 over n to k over n of f prime of 2k minus 1 over 2n times x minus 2k minus 1 over 2n plus f twice theta k x times over 2 times x minus 2k minus 1 over 2n square. Actually, the integration of this function x minus 2k minus 1 over 2n from k minus 1 over n to k over n is equal to 0. So we will just deal with the second term. Here, don't forget that f twice is continuous. Then we will consider capital M, okay, the supremum of f twice x, x taken between k over n and k minus 1 over n. This is a finite element. This element exists since f twice is continuous on an closed and bounded interval. Mk, the infimum of f twice k over n and k minus 1 over n. Then En will be squeezed between n square, the sum from k equal 1 to n, capital M k, the integral from k minus 1 over n to k over n of x over 2, this one, x minus 2k minus 1 over 2k to n square dx. And it is greater than n square over 2, the sum, little mk, the integral from k minus 1 over n to k over n, x minus 2k minus 1 over 2n square dx, k changes from 1 to n. This is an elementary integral which gives us less than or equal n square over 2 sum mk, k equal 1 to n, times 1 over 12 n power 3. This is an, and greater than or equal n square over 2 times k equal 1 to n, little mk, times 1 over 12 n power 3. Here we loss, this means that En is less than or equal 1 over 24 times 1 over n, the sum of capital Mk, k from 1 to n, and greater than or equal 1 over 24, 1 over n, the sum from k equal 1 to n, little mk. And we can remark that this is the sum, Riemann sum, and this is Riemann sum, upper and lower. And since f twice is continuous on enclosed and bounded interval, this means that Riemann integral exists and is equal, both of them converge to the integral from 0 to 1 of f twice of x dx. This means that This means that En, this means that En converge, squeeze theorem, converge to F prime of 1 minus F prime of 0 over 24 when N goes to plus infinity. This is about this limit. So the limit of N square integral from 0 to 1 F of x dx minus N the sum from k equal 1 to N F of 2k minus 1 over 2N goes to F prime of 1 minus F prime of 0 over 24 when N goes to plus infinity. As application, we can try to find the following limit application of this result, theoretical result. Let us try to find the two limits. The limit when n goes to plus infinity of 2 over 2n plus 2k minus 1 k 0 to n. And then this is the first question. The second question, n square ln 2 minus n, n square minus n, the sum from k equal 1 to n, f of 2k minus 1 over 2n when n goes to plus infinity. Just here we have an integral of the previous result. For the first question, we can just remark that the sum from k equal 1 to n, 2 over 2n plus 2k minus 1 is equal to 1 over n, the sum 2n over 2n plus 2k minus 1, k equal 1 to n. And if we take f of x equal 1 over 1 plus x, we will obtain 2k minus 1 over 2n. It will be exactly this one. So this gives us 2n over 2n plus 2k minus 1. So using the previous results about Riemann sums, here we recognize Riemann sum, and then this sequence converges to the integral from 0 to 1 dx over 1 plus x, which is equal to ln 2. About the second question, this question, what we can find, we recognize the first, the second formula. Then we have n square from 0 to 1 dx over 1 plus x minus n, the sum from k equal 1 to n of f of 2k over 2n minus 1. This formula converges to 1 over 24 times f prime of 1 minus f prime of 0, which is equal to 1 over 24 times the derivative of 1 over 1 plus x is minus 1 over 1 plus x square. This means that we have here 1 over 4 minus plus 1 over 24, which gives us 3 over 4 times 24, and it gives us 1 over 32. So the limit of this function Here we use this one, so n square ln minus n, and we use this function. This ends this video. I hope that it was benefic for you. Thank you for watching. See you next time.